I am, and that I am, that's what I am, and I do what I am, and what I do is who I am. He says, my name is tied up in it. If my name is not tied up, then it may be a possibility, but I put my name at stake. I put my reputation at stake because I'm saying that I am God. And if I tell you that, you might as well believe it, and you might as well bank on it and shout glory about what God is getting ready to do. And so the writers here, in many cases, tried to confirm that. Because it's only God that has to confirm his stuff. I mean, you can go to the doctors. They didn't have to bring the papers out to confirm that they finished school. And you just lay there because they tell you to. You close your eyes and he give you some medicine that you don't even ask what it is. Amen. If you go, amen, to the lawyer, you don't know how many cases he won, how many cases he lost. But you put your whole life in their hands and not think about it. But when it comes down to God, you're always saying, I want you to prove that you're God. Show me something. Amen. Reveal something to me that I'm God. God said, I ain't got to tell you nothing but myself. If I just say my word, then my word is enough. Amen. Because my word can't change. Heaven and earth shall pass away. Before any word that I say can come to the path, can somebody shout glory? Hallelujah. In other words, people would just believe God. If they could just believe God like they believe everybody else, then everything will work out to your advantage. Everything will be better for you. And so you have to go on record to confirm that I have made known, he said, the end from the beginning. He said, from the ancient time, amen, before anything ever come, he says, I already declare it. In other words, what he says through the mouth of Isaiah, he tells us from the days of old, which has not yet, amen, come, things still have not
reached.
He said, but I tell you before it happens. So when it happens, it becomes confirmation. Yeah. Amen. It just becomes confirmation. I did it when I said it. Everything was done when I said it. When I opened my mouth and said it, it was already done. You just didn't know it was done because you hadn't received it. But anytime that God opens his mouth and speaks, that's the last thing that comes out. Amen. And becomes the manifestation of what God says. In other words, can I put it like this? If you will, just to help you to understand, when God speaks, then, amen, that's differently than when God thinks. When God thinks, amen, he uses the word in him. When he speaks about his thought patterns, he said in him, amen, that means that in his mind, he already has a plan. He already has a strategy when he speaks about in him. When he says in him, it's the thoughts. It's the thoughts that is already in his head. It is the wisdom that is really turning over with the knowledge that he has. It's a fathering of his understanding and knowledge is there when he speaks about in him. In other words, everything that is in God did not have come out yet. Everything that's in the mind of God, amen, is never manifested until he says it. In other words, the seeing aspect is the last part of his creative
the last part.
Act. Because
my God,
anybody speaks, it's a creative act of God. That's why God makes us open our mouth and say things, because it becomes a creative act. That's why we got to say it. You don't get anything because you don't ask for nothing. You got to open your mouth and say it. You got to say, I am blessed, even though you're not dead. You're creating your future by things that you say. You're creating because you have words that have the ability to create things that come from God. And when God opens his mouth and says, it's already done. You may not receive it too much years later, but God said, it's already done. When I open my mouth and said, it's already out there. All you got to do is wait till you come to get it. And then you'll verify, say, he gave me just what he said. And I got what he says. Can somebody here shout glory? Can you shout hallelujah? In other words, that's what makes God so good. In other words, can I just throw this in here? I'm going to tell you right now that there's a difference between praying. And you got to understand, praying is when you actually, I believe, that you pray out loud. Now, I know everybody don't go along with that, but I believe that when you pray, you got to pray out loud. I believe that every prayer that you heard read in the Bible is somebody had to say them out loud. I don't believe that prayer is silent. I don't believe that there is nowhere that you read about anybody praying silently. I understand that they would say Hannah prayed, but Hannah lost words. She started out praying, but it ended up in a groaning kind of a situation. And the reason why I believe it, because I believe that whenever you're thinking a prayer, or whenever you have something in your mind that you have not said, it's called meditating. Y'all understand, there's a difference between meditating and praying. Meditating is when I rethink some things that I've already thought about or heard. But when I said, I put things to action, what's in my mind like God does, and I begin to create a future that somebody said it can't happen. I pray out loud for people, and people that's out of the country get healed because you pray out loud, and you create a healing because you pray out loud, and God heard the word that was said, and God's got to honor it. Can somebody shout glory? Y'all ain't with me yet, but that's all right. In other words, this is why the text becomes so interesting, because what he does, he tells us from the days of old. He said, I still tell it. I speak about things that's undone. I speak about things that have not come. And from the beginning, he said, I foretell the outcome in advance, and things that have not yet come, not yet happened, but they will happen. That's the way God does. In other words, this is why he speaks this promise to everybody, because now you know that God is involved in creating your situation. You now know that God is involved in the outcome of whatever that comes into your life. You recognize it's just not standing in your hands, or it's not left up with a circumstance or a situation to come out. You know now that God is in control, because God made the promise. Then God's got to fulfill the promise that he's already made. In other words, the thought didn't give hope to where you are now. I need some help right now. I know that there are some people that is going through some stuff, but you need some help right now. You need some word from God that will strengthen you right now. You need some kind of word to come from God that will tell you that everything is going to be all right. You need some kind of help that whatever the doctor declared, I said, I got a feeling that everything gonna come out and work for my good. In other words, the thought gives hope to people, because people need to know that you're not in this thing and you're not going to die in the situation that you're in. You need to know that God is in control. You need to know that there is an outcome of this, and there is something that God's going to do that's going to make things better than what it is. Can somebody shout hallelujah? In other words, that's why many times you hear people say, is there any word from the Lord? Have y'all ever been there? Have you ever been in a situation and all you want to do is hear a word from the Lord? Look like when you hear a word from God, look like the weight have come off of your back. When you hear a word from God, you know that seems like that God, amen, is on your side. When you hear a word from God, somehow you get some strength that you never had before, and you're able to stand up to some things that you never stood up before, because there is a word from God. Shake somebody, say, have you heard the word yet? Amen. When your situation come, the reason why you pray is because you want a word from God. You said, any way you want to stoop me, Lord, any way you want to bless me, Lord, I'll be satisfied. In other words, this is why the text becomes interesting to us, from where they are and what they're going through. God gives a word of hope. In other words, the words indicates to every child of God that whatever, amen, is ahead of you, it grows out of what has been in your past. Now, what he is saying to the church is that whatever you're going to be, it has to have a beginning. Amen. It just doesn't start with where you are. God does not just start with where you are. If God's going to take you to another place, God cannot start right here where you are. But whatever it is, your future is going to grow out of your past. That means that everything in your past had to be necessary for you to get to where you are now. Amen. You needed the experiences that God allowed you to have in the past, so you can deal with what's ahead of you, so you can deal with whatever God is getting ready to do to you. That's why you can't get mad about what you're going through, because God knows that it takes this to get you to that, and God knows that you gotta have out some disappointments over here so you can have some appreciation over there. God knows you got to take rejections